My name is Ed Fasella, and I'm the artistic director at Maine State Center for the Arts, who's sponsoring this concert tonight of the Pine Barrens annual concert. For those of you who are new to Main Stage, I know you all know the Pine Barrens. Main Stage is a performing arts center, and we're located in Blackwood, Washington Township, and we do our performances here. We've been doing shows for 28 years. We have a large summer program for kids that's called Summer Stage. We take kids from as young as 5 years old, and we really take them through college and up to age 25, and we have a 7-week program. So if you know of any kids who are looking to sing and dance and want to be with other kids who love to sing and dance, have them come out and see us. And also, we have a show next week that you may like. It's called The Complete Works of Shakespeare Abridged. It's abridged, 37 Shakespearean plays in 90 minutes. And it's a professional show, professional actors. It's a great comedy. It's very, very funny. It's one of the funniest shows around, and we hope that you'll come out and see it. And also, we have something else coming up for the ladies especially, but guys, you're welcome too. It's a designer bag bingo. So you can get information on all of that on the table in the lobby, and we're also taking a raffle over there for our tickets for Shakespeare. And if you sign your name to our mailing list, we'll pick 2 tickets for next week's show, and if you win, you get them for free. The Pine Barrens have a lot of stuff out on the table, so at intermission, make sure you get up and stretch and go out and see all the stuff that they have to offer. But right now, I have to tell you, I am very excited to present to you the Pine Barrens Barbershop Chorus.
Well, how's everybody doing this evening? Good, you all got here okay, right? Okay, very good. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Pine Barrens annual show Decision 2016. And actually, before we begin, just a quick reminder to please take a moment to silence your cell phones, okay? So maybe one of the ringtones would be in the same pitch as another pitch that we're trying to pitch a song. So, you know. Okay. So in any case, onward we go. This year, as you all know, is a presidential election year. And with it comes seemingly endless hours of candidate debate, as we all have been seeing. So while these debates have captured headlines in our newspapers, and are deemed breaking news on TV, another debate has been quietly taking place that's even of greater importance to music lovers around the world. Now, the old traditional a cappella style of singing known as barbershop is under attack by a new age a cappella singing group whose contemporary music is almost exclusively their own. So, this debate is happening right here and right now. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, the Pine Barren Barbershop Chorus.
Everything you do will turn out.
Right away.
It's a good day for paying your bills and singing in tune on a wonderful morning like this, like this. I said to the sun, good morning, sun, rise and shine today.
You know you gotta get going if you're gonna make a showing.
Thank you. our love should stand so deep in your eyes. A touch on you more and more every time. When you leave, I'm begging you not to go. Call your name two or three times in a row. Such a funny thing for me to try to explain. How I'm feeling in my pride is the one to blame. Yeah, cause I know I don't understand. Just how you love and doing no one else can. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your touch got me looking so crazy right now. Got me open, you beat me right now. Your kiss got me hoping you save me right now. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy in love. In a talk to my friend so quietly,
who we think he is?
Look at what you did to me. Teenage girls don't even need to buy a new dress. If you were there, got nobody else to impress. The way that you knew what I thought I knew. It's the beat that my heart skips when I'm with you. But I still don't understand. It's how love can do it on else can. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your touch got me looking so crazy right now. Got me hoping you'll page me right now. Your kiss got me hoping you'll save me right now. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy in love. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy in love. I've been playing myself, baby, I don't care. Cause your love's got the best of me. Baby, you're making a fool of me. You got me sprung and I don't care who sees. Baby,
you got me
so crazy, baby. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your touch got me looking so crazy right now. Got me open, you'll beat me right now. Your love got me hope you see me right now. Looking so crazy, love. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy in love.
Well, that wasn't really awful. What else do you got?
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Man, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays, and now I see you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side, and now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day.
It's been a long day
without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
See you again.
We've come a long way from where we began.
You know where we started.
Oh, I tell you all about it when I see you again.
Yeah.
When I see you again.
Come on.
Whoa.
First you both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong. What's small turns to a friendship, that friendship turns to a bond. On that bond will never get broken, that love will never get lost. Cause when brotherhood comes first, and that line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. On that line is what we will reach, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way, yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you home. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again. When I see you again.
Well, we've got to get going, but we'll see you at the debate.
Interesting.
You old guys sort of like those corny old songs from yesteryear.
You don't even know what yesteryear means. Get out of here.
Good old days, good old days, bring them back again.
Shenandoah, I love your dog. Thank you very much, everyone. It's great to see everyone here this evening. And in selection of our songs to sing for you this evening, we figured since the theme of the show this year is kind of a contrast of traditional barbershop singing and that new age a cappella sound, well, we'll leave that to them. We thought we would take you on a musical journey through the musical vocal history of this country. So we just sang for you a traditional folk tune, Shenandoah, that actually dates back to the early parts of the 19th century. We don't even know who wrote the song, but we're just thankful that they did. This was a time of westward expansion, of lives on the river moving up and down, and as people lived their lives and moved with the flow and ebb of time, they brought with them their musical culture. And a song like Shenandoah would just be passed down, and we can still enjoy that today. By the end of the 19th century, our friend Thomas Edison had invented the phonograph record. And with that, the birth of the music industry, really. People could now enjoy music in their homes on the phonograph, which then gave insight for musicians and music writers to start writing more music. So if you were sitting in Lower Manhattan in the early part of the 20th century in Tin Pan Alley, you might hear all those songwriters busy plunking out what they thought might be the next great hit. And that brings us then into the roaring 20s, emblematic of the jazz age. We now turn to the pen and the creativity of the great Ira and George Gershwin. Our song from 1928 tonight is kind of an aha song, meaning that you've all heard it, but you won't recognize it right away. But then, hopefully, you'll go, aha, that's what they're singing.
Or not.
Or not. Yeah. No, they look like a pretty smart group.
Dozens of girls would storm up. I had to lock my door. Somehow I couldn't warm up to one before. What was it that controlled me? What kept my love life lean? My intuition told me you'd come on the scene.
Lady, listen to the rhythm of my heartbeat. And you get just what I mean.
Come embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Come embrace me, you irreplaceable you. Just one look at you, my heart grew tipsy in me. You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me. How I love all the many charms about you. And you should know, above all, I want my arms about you. I want to hold you.
darling. Take a chance that I'll entrance you too. My sweet embraceable you. Just one look at you, my heart grew tipsy in me. You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me. I love all the many charms about you.
And did you know?
Above all, I want my arms about you. I want to hold you, darling. Dance with me, romance with me. My sweet embraceable, my irreplaceable, my irreplaceable, embraceable you.
So where were we? We were back in the year 1928. Some of our friends remember that very well. No, not a chance. So we're going to move now another generation ahead. We've now have music at home, music at work, music industry, music for theater, music for plays, music for the movies. And now we're going to give homage to that, let's say, the Rat Pack era, the nightclub scene. I mean, because no trip through the musical memory lane would be correct without including the chairman of the board, Old Blue Eyes. No, not you.
You do have blue eyes.
She's old.
So our next song, written by the great Sammy Kahn for the Rat Pack, for Frank Sinatra, another I Know That Song song.
Babe, here's what's on my mind. Let's you and me unwind. So pack your bag and let's leave it all behind. Yeah, come fly with me. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me. Let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band and a toot. His flute for you.
Come fly with me. Let's take off in the blue.
Off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide. We'll just be starry-eyed. Together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the word and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a fly-in honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me. Come on, let's fly away. Come on, babe, let's touch the sky. Come on. Let's fly.
So now we're going to move it forward yet another notch, another generation later. We have some music now, really the music industry, combining movies and theater and even home TV and video and DVDs at home. So we're going to turn, who does that better than Disney? Our next song, our final song from 1988 movie, The Little Mermaid. Thanks, everybody.
There you see her, sitting there across the way. She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her. And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl. Yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do. Possible she wants you to. There is one way to ask her. It don't take a word, not a single word. You wanna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, my oh my. Looks like the boy too shy. Ain't gonna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame? Too bad he's gonna miss the girl. She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her. And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared. You got the mood prepared. You're gonna kiss the girl. Go kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now. Don't try to hide it how you wanna. Kiss the girl, kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, float along and listen to the song. The song say, kiss the girl, kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, music play to what the music say. You gotta kiss the girl. You've got to kiss the girl. You wanna kiss the girl. You wanna kiss the girl.
Thanks, everybody.
So I pulled over,
And he started to watch him for a little while. And he reeled in, he reeled. Nothing was on it. And then, to my amazement, he did it again. Cast his line out, went down the grate, waited for a little while. And I saw a little ripple on the wire there, pulled it up, and still nothing was there. So at this point, I get out of the car, and you know what? I just gotta watch this guy for a little while longer. So sure enough, he cast a third time. And same thing, across the street, hit the grate, the line went down in. He pulled it up, and nothing again. So at this point, I said, you know what? I've got to go over and ask this guy. So I said, listen, I said I've been watching you for a little while. What do you call it? Anything today? He said, well, you're the third one. Anyway, we continue as folks are piling into the convention center here. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the great a cappella debate of 2016. And without further ado, please welcome our moderator for this evening with the ANN Network, Wolf Blitzer.
Thank you very much, Eric. I'm Wolf Blitzer from the ACNN, that's the a cappella news network. I'd like to thank all of you for coming here for this important and historical conversation, and especially to our guests today for taking time out of their busy schedules to be here to discuss their points of view. Defending traditional barbershop values, to my right we have businessman mogul Donald Trump and New Jersey Governor Chris Christie. And on the other side of the aisle, defending
I apologize for my tardiness, but all these buildings look the same around here. Excuse me, sir, I believe you're in my spot. Right here, Sanders, right there. That's me.
No. Colonel Sanders, your debate, you know, the one about why did the chicken cross the road, that's on the other side of the campus.
I apologize again. I am sorry. Thank you for setting me straight. You look like you could use a piece of chicken. It's finger licking good.
Don't encourage him. I don't know how this happens every year. Sorry. On the other side of the a cappella aisle, we have former First Lady, former New York Senator, Secretary of State, Ms. Hillary Clinton, and Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders. So the ground rules today, each of our participants will have 30 seconds to give an introduction and explain why they are advocating a particular a cappella vocal form. We begin with you, Mr. Trump.
Everybody knows who I am. I'm the Donald from New York City, and I'm here to protect the barbershop style.
Protect it
from being polluted, from being watered down by a bunch of nobodies who have absolutely no respect for tradition. If I have to, and I will, with my own money, purchase the entire Barbershop Harmony Society just to make it safe. Let's make barbershop again.
Let's make barbershop great again.
That would be huge. Mr. Christie, to you.
I'm Chris Christie, and I agree with my colleague, Mr. Trump. We are going to save traditional barbershop because we love that old barbershop sound. When I hear a quartet sing, I get goosebumps all over, and the hair stands up on my arms. And I feel like telling everybody to just sit down, shut up, and listen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Christie. Now to the other side of the aisle, Ms. Clinton, ladies first.
Ms. Clinton, you'll have to put your cell phone away. You can check your email later.
I'm Hillary Clinton, and I approve this message. Also, all of this will be posted on my Facebook page at the end of the day. I'm here to support our youth.
Happy days are here again.
Looks like somebody forgot to turn off their cell phone.
I think that's mine.
That's you're not mine.
Not mine.
It's just more spam from the White House. Delete. Oh. Now, where was I?
I'm sorry, Ms. Clinton, your time is up. And now everybody's favorite grandfather image, Senator Bernie Sanders.
Bernie.
Thank you, Wolf, for that very kind introduction. It is true, I am the oldest person on this stage. But I'm young at heart, and I love these Johnny-come-latelys with their fresh new sound. You've heard a lot about tradition, and tradition is fine up to a point. But this is no longer a sport just for old men. If acapella singing is to survive, we need change. We need new blood. We need young faces. We need young voices. We need a vocal revolution. Without change, there will be no tomorrow.
Thank you, Mr. Sanders, for your interesting perspective. Ms. Clinton, the first question is for you. Can you explain to our audience why you think it's time for traditional barbershoppers to move over and make room for these new guys?
According to an email I got from the president himself, barbershopping comes from the days of radio, when people actually sat and listened to the radio. Those days are long gone. It's time to face facts. Today is all about video. MTV, YouTube. It's time to surrender your old phonographs and get with the times.
One, two, three, four.
What na 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 wa na wa na na what na 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 na. I was running on an empty heart, not a trace of gasoline. Trying to fill every single spark that could hurt, that could burn all of me. Like a soldier on the battleground, lying wounded on the field. I was fighting alone with a broken sword. Now I'm caught in a war with no shield. If you hold me now and leave me never, say you'll stay with me forever, and I'll surrender, surrender. And I'll surrender, surrender. Video killed the radio stars. 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 I heard you on the wireless back in 52, lying awake antenna turning it on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming through. Oh, oh. They took the credit for your second symphony, rewritten by machine and new technology. And now I understand the problems you can see. Oh, oh. I met your children. Oh, oh. What did you tell them?
You hold me now and leave me never. Say you'll stay with me
forever, and I'll surrender, surrender. Video kill the radio star. 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 And I'll surrender, surrender.
Trump, our next question is for you. Just want to get it out of the way. What's with the hair?
For the last time, this is not a toupee, this is my real hair.
I see that you brought your own barber along as well.
Oh, as a matter of fact, I did. This is Joe. Come down here, Joe. This is Joe, everybody. Joe, I found on 47th Street in the shop. And he is probably the best barber I've ever met. Probably, he's an amazing barber. He's just amazing. He does amazing things with scissors. He's an amazing, wonderful guy, and he's an amazing barber. And you know, with my busy schedule, I'm in and out and all over the place. I don't have time to get a haircut. And you know, I hire Joe here, and I take him wherever I go.
I see that he had a little trouble there with the razor.
Oh yeah, thanks for reminding me. Joe? You're fired.
That's okay, Mr. Trump. You know, I was itching to get back to my old shop on 47th Street. And to tell you the truth, working on your hair, a little like working on an orangutan. I much prefer the old classic haircuts and that old barbershop style.
I'll be the last guy hanging around to barbershop sound, that sound. I've never tried it, but I like to sing those barbershop chords when they ring, when they ring.
Sing me a song.
Is for you. I noticed that when Ms. Clinton's cell phone went off, you reached for your shirt pocket. Can you explain to our audience why you keep your cell phone in your shirt pocket?
Oh, yes, there are two reasons. First, I keep my phone here because it's close to my good ear. And when I have it on vibrate, it acts as my defibrillator. Now,
You have a real question? Or should we just shut up and dance?
Oh, don't you dare look back, just keep your eyes on me. I sense you're holding back. She says, shut up and dance for me. This woman is my destiny. She said, ooh, ooh, shut up and dance for me.
We were victims of the night. The chemical, physical, kryptonite. Helpless to the pace and the fading light. Oh, we were bound to get together. Bound to get together. She took my arm. I don't know how it happened.
Why so serious? So raise your dialogue back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding my back. She said shut up and dance.
Never be
this woman is my destiny. She said shut up and dance with me.
Right, right, turn off the lights. We're gonna lose our minds tonight. What's the dealio? I love when it's all too much. 5 a.m. turn the radio up. Where's the rock and roll?
Shut up and dance with me.
Party crasher, panty snatcher. Call me up if you're a gangster. Don't be fancy, just get dancy. Why so serious?
Oh, so raise your dance look back.
I want and all the right ways on my back.
And you said shut up and
we will never be any woman out. And
it's
pretty dirty.
Shut up and dance on board.
Don't raise your glasses back.
Just keep your eyes on me.
I said you hold my back.
She said shut up and dance.
We will never be anything but
my destiny.
And it's pretty dirty little freak.
Shut up and dance.
So raise your glass.
Now, in my research this evening, I learned that, in preparation for tonight's discussion, that the Barbershop Harmony Society's headquarters is in Nashville, Tennessee, the music capital of this country. Now, with that in mind, can someone please explain to me how it was decided to have this debate here in Blackwood, New Jersey?
Well, I was thinking the exact same thing, Wolf. This is the state that gave us singers like John Bon Jovi, who is a great guy, by the way, a wonderful guy, an amazing singer. And he's done some amazingly wonderful things for the wonderful people of the state of New Jersey. He's a great guy. And Bruce Springsteen, another great, great, wonderful, amazing guy. Well, these two guys never sang Barbershop. As a matter of fact, they're responsible for these newfangled songs, kind of, that the other party's trying to cram down our throats. I think that this is the worst place that you could have a convention like this.
Hey, I'm from New Jersey, and I wouldn't even make those kinds of statements. We have some great barbershop singers. Now, back to the original question. I checked on the internet, and I found out that the Nashville Convention Center was booked.
Hey, guys. I invented the internet.
Mr. Gore, no one cares what you think. In fact, no one ever cares what you think.
Anyway, where did you want to have this convention? Florida, where all the old people go to avoid New Jersey's high taxes?
Be careful, Chris. We're going to be those old people soon.
When I get older, losing my hair so many years from now, will you still be sending me a Valentine?
riverside, Sunday morning go for a ride, doing the garden, digging the weeds, who could ask for more? Will you still need me, will you still feed me, when I'm 64? Every summer we can rent a cottage at the Jersey Shore, if it's not too near, we shall scrimp. Precisely what you mean to say, you're sincerely wasting away. Give me your answer, fill in the form, my forevermore. Will you still need me, will you still feed me, when I'm 64, four, when I'm 64.
Ms. Clinton, a question for you. Since your side is advocating for the new style of a cappella singing, perhaps there's some middle ground, perhaps a way we could bridge the tradition from the old and the new.
Well, first of all, when it comes to questions about bridges, I think you should be asking Mr. Christie.
Look, I'm sick and tired of those questions about bridges. I had nothing to do with Bridgegate, nothing. Why don't you ask me about something important, like something you guys messed up, like global warming and the environment?
That's enough. This is not the time or the place to be talking about the weather. I, for one, would like to hear these young men sing another song.
Dan?
And all I am is a man. I want the world in my hands. I hate the beach, but I stand in California with my toes in the sand. Use the sleeves of my sweater, let's have an adventure. Head in the clouds, but my gravity centered. Touch my neck and I'll touch yours, you and those little high-waisted shorts. Oh, she knows what I think about, what I think about. One love, 2 miles, one love, one house. No shirt, no blouse, just us, you find out. Nothing that I wanna want to tell you about, no, cause it's too cold for you here and now, so let me hold. Holds up my sweater, and if I may just take your breath away, I don't mind if it's not much to say. Sometimes the silence guides your mind, so move to a place so far away. Goosebumps start to race the minute that my left hand meets your waist, and I watch your face, put your finger on my tongue, you love the taste, yeah. These hearts are doors, everyone the other beats heart is for. Inside this place is warm, oh, outside it starts to pour. Coming down, one love, 2 miles, one love, one house. No shirt, no blouse, just us, you find out. Nothing that I wanna want to tell you about. No, 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 cause it's too cold for you here and now, so let me hold both your hands in the holes of my sweater. Oh, 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 oh. And now, so let me hold both your hands in the holes of my sweater. It's too cold, the holes of my sweater.
Welcome back. I'd like to get back to the discussion point of the venue for the convention. Mr. Trump, a hypothetical for you. Another great location is New Orleans. Now, assuming, hypothetically, that we did have the convention in New Orleans, when would be a good time of year to have it there?
Well, absolutely, it would have to be Mardi Gras.
Oh, you know, I invented Mardi Gras, too.
Mr. Gore, you have been warned. One more outburst from you, and you go back into timeout.
I've been in New Orleans during Mardi Gras, and it's wonderful. It's so exciting. You can hear barbershop, the blues, jazz, street performers. It's fantastic. I even remember a time about a baseball player for a team called the Mudville Nine. He was a player who struck out only one time in his career, but he was quite a hit.
That's right. I think his name was Casey, if I remember. And as a matter of fact, when he retired, he went into ballroom dancing.
The man called Casey hired the place. He even paid the band. Then he met the fairest Colleen there. How he loved to take her hand. Would you care to dance? He gently tried. Well, perhaps just once, she gently sighed. Then he turned and wink by a round of drink. And the band knew what to do. With the strawberry blonde, and the band played on. He'd glide across the floor with the girl he adored, and the band played on. But his brain was so loaded it nearly exploded. The poor girl would shake with alarm. He'd marry the girl with the strawberry curls, and the band played on and on, and the band played on and on, the band played on. He'd marry the girl with the strawberry curls, and the band played on.
The band played on.
How that band would play. The band played on.
And the band.
And the band would play. Parabolia.
Oh, yes. debate goes on. Only terrible, because, ladies and gentlemen, we will now have a 15-minute intermission. Okay, so everybody synchronize your watches. Here we go. Synchronizing their watches. All right, so 15 minutes, mark. Okay, now, while we're in intermission, I'd like to ask you to ballot, do the ballot thing that they have boxes out there for all of that. Okay, so ballot boxes are in the lobby where our Barron's Court lady is charging it. They are. Have some also refreshments, crafts, raffle tickets too. And remember to vote early and often. So also please remember that the raffle tickets, by the way, are for a basket of cheer worth $80. If you take a look at it, it's out in the lobby there. So lots of really cool stuff. And by the way, if you notice too, we've taken the extra time and trouble to theme everything in sort of a political context. So an extra bonus right there. And by the way, we also have a couple of $25 gift certificates to Tonzio's Diner on Route 70. So all kinds of stuff. But wait, there's more. Give us your name and email, and we'll put you in a drawing for two great prizes. But that's not all. The lovely and talented ladies of the Barron's Court have an assortment of home-baked cookies, brownies, and delicious breads, too, in case I didn't already mention. So, anyway, let's see. All right, everybody, mark 15 minutes. We'll see you back then. And, ladies and gentlemen, it is our pleasure to present the husband and wife team of Jeff and Jillian Wien. Soon to be joined, by the way, by another junior member of their team. Now, I'm inserting the Villanova score here for a reason. We'll see why in a second. All right? So, Nova won 95 to 51. Now, you'll understand why I put the score in now when I continue, okay? So, Oklahoma was also a musical, if you may remember. Okay, so this talented duo I just introduced a moment ago will sing a Rodgers and Hammerstein tune made popular in 1945. It's the musical Carousel, okay? And Carousel, of course, the characters of Billy Bigelow and Julie Jordan, through the following song, hesitantly declare their love for one another, but are too shy to reveal their feelings. So please extend a warm round of applause to Jeff and Jillian Wien as they sing If I Love You.
When I worked at the mill, weaving at the loom, I'd gaze absent-minded at the room. And half the time the shuttle tangle in the thread and the warped get mixed with the woof. If I loved you. But somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be.
Time and again I would try to say all I'd want you to know.
If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way round in circles.
My golden chances pass me by.
Soon.
All right. Well, we have a special guest quartet tonight, and the Pine Barrens Chorus obviously is pleased to present our featured quartet of the evening. Hailing from New Jersey, Delaware, and Virginia, they represent the Mid-Atlantic District of our Barbershop Harmony Society, and they just formed actually a few months ago. So, this is their debut performance tonight. You're hearing it first. Please welcome the smooth sounds of the Bourbon Street Four.
Well, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the Golden Avenue. There are mansions left and right, and you thrill every sight, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you know? It's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you weren't an idol, took time to read your Bible. It's a great, great morning for you. I had a dream, and I confess I needed to awake. I dreamt I was an angel at the great pearly gates. St. Peter said, well, hello there, where have you been? We've got your mansion ready, so come right in.
And he rang for his angel to act as his guide.
He spread his wings a time or two and learn how to fly.
Great morning, that first day in heaven, strolling down that golden avenue. Whoa, mansions left and right, you thrill at every sign, and the saints are always smiling. Gonna keep you smiling on that great, great morning. When you get to heaven and you tell it all you worries, goodbye, goodbye.
Say, oh, open that gate, well, I can hardly wait
for that great blessed morning. Gonna go and fly, I'm ready for that sweet by and by, the land of above in the sky.
Exciting, it's vibrant and so new.
I try to tell you often just how much I love you.
So I sat down a minute to give you one more clue. Just pardon me and you will see as I spell it out for just for you. Well, it's for the way you look at me. And O is for the only one that I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. And love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you.
I'm telling you that
L is for the way you look. You're looking at me and O. For the only one that I see. V is so very, very extraordinary. Now E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. It's all that I'm gonna give, I'll give to you. Love is more than just a game for two and two, just two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love, sweet love, was made for me and you, only you. I'm telling you, love was made for me and you.
you know it's true. Those four little letters I'm dreaming of just keep me coming back for love. It's L-O-V-E, love. Thank the stars above. L-O-V-E, love. Be my love.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the Bourbon Street Four who have come to you from all over the greater Northeast to perform at Camden County Community College. We have arrived.
Oh, yeah.
From the day this quartet formed, we had two goals: Carnegie Hall and Camden County Community College. All right?
Nice.
Where we see it, we're halfway to Carnegie Hall, right? Not bad, not bad. We were able to get out today. You know, we like to perform for folks like you, and we've done so in our respective quartets over the years. And so when we got here this afternoon, we decided to kind of take a stroll and just kind of chat a little bit. We're still getting to know each other on some level and having some fun as a quartet. So we took a walk down the road there and actually happened upon this really beautiful church. I forget the name of it. It was down the road just a bit, and beautiful architecture and stained glass and so forth. And the priest was out there in the front of the church, and he's kind of caring for the lawn a little bit, kind of putting in some flowers and doing some weeding and so forth, when right down the sidewalk came the cutest little thing. She must have been 8 years old. Little Susie came down, and she had little curly pigtails, and she was pushing her little baby cart with her doll baby in it, you know, and there, here she comes down the road, and she hit a crack in the sidewalk or a pothole or something, and a wheel fell off of her little baby carriage. Well, she got so upset, she balled up her little fist and her face turned red and she yelled, "Damn!"
Wow. Really?
She did. Right out loud. And, the priest was not happy about that. He ran right over to little Susie. He knew her from Sunday school. And he said, "Now, Susie, you know better than that. We've talked about how to control your anger. We don't use language like that, especially in front of the house of the Lord. Now, the next time you feel your anger rising up like that, I want you to fold your little hands and take a deep breath and say a prayer. Ask the Lord to help you control yourself a little bit better." She said, "Okay, Father, I will, I will." And he said, "All right, now let's get this carriage back together." And he got the wheel back on and patted her on her head and got her down the sidewalk. Well, she didn't get 10 feet down the sidewalk. She hit another bump. All four wheels fell off the wagon. And you could see it. Her little face turned beet red, and she clenched her teeth at her fists, and then she took a deep breath and folded her pretty little hands, and she said a little prayer. And with that, there was a great flash of light, and the wagon rose off the sidewalk, and all four wheels smacked themselves back onto the wagon. The preacher saw this, and he said, "Damn!" It was really
nice.
I mean,
you love me, you leave me, and now you say you grieve me. I knew it would happen all along, that sooner or later you're gonna be coming around. I'll bet ya, you know, I'll bet ya. I'll bet you that I'll get ya, that I get ya. You wait and see, you wait and see. And sooner or later you're gonna be hanging around. I'll let ya, I just might let ya. I'll bet ya if I let ya. See, you're gonna knock on my door. You know you did it before. Matter of fact, I don't know exactly when, but sooner or later you're gonna be coming around, around, and want my loving again. I'm wise that you want it, I know it, but you
you're too shy to show it. Why must I wait until you ask me? You ask me. I love it, I'm for it. You know we can't ignore it. Why must I wait until you ask me? The slightest bit of encouragement is all that I would need.
I'd waste no time in showing you
how wonderful it would be, my honey. So come now, I ask you, what harm can one little kiss do? Why must I wait until you ask me?
Come on,
well,
ask me
now. Sooner than later, I'm coming around.
Both of us know
I'm lost and I'm found. I'll betcha, I said, I'll betcha. I'll bet you when I get ya, you know I'll get ya. You baby me and only me.
Poor little me.
You wait and see. Come on and knock on my door. You've been there before. Soon as you ask me, I'll tell you exactly when. So sooner or later, you're gonna be coming around, around. And want my loving again and again. You and I'll be loving
again.
Knock on the door. You've been there before.
Wow.
It's all right.
It's kind of fun.
It's kind of fun. I love it. As the MC said, we are the Bourbon Street Four, of course, and this is our very first performance as a brand new quartet, and we're so excited about that. We formed just over a few months back, shortly after the new year, and started cramming and learning a bunch of new music, and we just couldn't be more excited about the future and doing all these shows and singing for fine people like you. It's just a lot of fun, and we're thrilled to do it. You know, when you're traveling around doing shows like this, it's neat. You see a lot of wacky things going on out there. I mean, one time we went out to lunch. It was quartet. I was actually when Dan and I were singing years ago. And we walked into this place and sitting there having a burger at this bar. And a fellow walked into the bar and he says, "Hey, you know, my name's Bob. I know everybody and they all know me." Kind of weird, but people kind of chuckled a little bit. And yeah, whatever, buddy. You know. And he goes on and on. And the bartender says, "All right, pal, whatever, I got it. You know everybody. I'll bet you don't know Kenny Rogers." And he says, "Well, I do know Kenny Rogers. And if you're willing to go to the concert here in town tonight, I'll prove it to you." Sure, so they did. They went to the concert there that night, and the lights went down, and the band started playing. Out comes Kenny Rogers and says, "This one's for you, Bob."
Wow.
Oh, that's pretty impressive. Yeah. Kind of a big deal, I think. Next morning, they're back in the bar there, and sure enough, Bob's in there like clockwork, and the bartender says, "No, I've been thinking, buddy, I'll bet you don't know President Barack Obama." "Well, I do know him, and if you're willing to go to the press conference in town here, I'll prove it to you." So they did. They went on to the press conference, and the Marine snapped to attention, and out comes the president. Before he began his address to the people, he says, "Hey, Bob, we got to get you over to the White House for dinner." It's cray-cray. Right? So the next day, the bartender's sitting there, and he had been thinking long and hard, really long and hard. How am I going to stump this guy? And sure enough, Bob came in like clockwork. He says, "You know, I've been thinking all night about this, Bob. I'll bet you don't know the Pope." Figured he had him this time. And he says, "Well, you know, I don't know how to break it to you, buddy, but I do know the Pope. And if you're willing to fly to Rome, I'll prove it to you." So they did. They hopped on a plane, flew all the way to Rome, and when they got off the plane, there were 30,000 people standing in the courtyard waiting for the Pope to come out and address everyone. And Bob says, "Listen, pal, he's never going to see me down here. I mean, there's 30,000 people. I'll go into the cathedral, and I'll come out at the Pope's right-hand side, and that'll prove to you that I know it. Okay, fair enough. So Bob made his way through the crowd. About 20, 25 minutes passed, and the trumpets sounded, and the doves flew, and out comes the Pope. And standing at his right-hand side,
not me,
was Bob. And the bartender was so blown away by this, he passed out cold right there in the courtyard. So Bob politely dismissed himself from the Pope. He made his way back down through the crowd, of course, and he's splashing water on his friend's face and trying to get him to come to. And the guy comes to, he says, "Man, I can't believe this. You know Kenny Rogers, one of the greatest entertainers of all time. You know the leader of the free world, the president of the United States of America, and you know the Pope. But what really blew me away was this nun standing next to me. She tapped me on the shoulder and says, 'Hey, who's that guy up there with Bob?'"
Nice.
It's familiar, I don't know. True story. True story.
First one.
Now. I didn't get it, I'm sorry. I didn't hear that.
I volunteered one summer day to journey over there and save the world for liberty. My country's arms to bear. And kiss my girls, then heard their frightened plea. "We'll miss you, Daddy, please don't go." Then their mother said to me, "For now is the hour when we must say goodbye. Soon you'll be sailing far across the sea or the sea. But in your heart, please
This is not our land. It's not our land. Goodbye. I love you till I die. My love, it's not your last.
Pass me by one summer day, flash those big brown eyes my way, and oh, I wanted you forevermore. I'm not one that gets around, swear my feet stuck to the ground, and though I never did meet you before, I said hello, Mary Lou.
Goodbye, heart.
Goodbye, heart, sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you.
I'm in love with Mary Lou.
I knew Mary Lou
that
we'd never part, so hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart,
goodbye, heart. Saw your lips, I heard your voice. Believe me, I just had no choice. Horses couldn't make me stay away.
Thought about our moonlit night, arms about you, good and tight. That's all I need to see for me to stay.
Hey, hey, hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart.
Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you.
I'm in love with Mary Lou.
I knew Mary Lou.
We'd never part.
So hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart.
Goodbye, heart.
Hello, Mary Lou. I'm in love with you, yes. Hello, Mary Lou.
Goodbye, heart.
Right from the start, I said hello.
Thanks so much, folks. You know, I'd like to just take a quick opportunity here and introduce the quartet and let you know who's working up here for you so hard. I tell you what, you have been a great audience. I mean, just great. If I had known you were going to be such a great audience, well, we'd have practiced a lot more, that's for sure. I mean, we'd have been a lot more ready. Over here on my right-hand side, he sings our baritone part. He lives down in Leesburg, Virginia, where he works for the government. That's right, very hush-hush. I'd love to tell you exactly what he does, but we'd have to actually gas the entire theater, and that's no fun. But just know that you're safer because of what he does, okay? He sings a great baritone part, and he's been in several quartets over the years, winning several Mid-Atlantic District Quartet Championships and performing on the international stage. Please say hello to Mike Pinto. And over here on my left, singing the big booming bass part, he hails from, what's that town called?
Little New Egypt.
New Egypt. New Egypt, New Jersey. Yeah. Right here in his own backyard. He sings the bass part and he works in telecommunications, where he works very diligently all day, keeping everybody connected to their machines and gadgets and keeping everyone plugged in. And please say hello to Dan Van Wettering. You know, in every quartet, there's always that one guy, you know, and he's sort of at the center of it all, the glue that kind of holds it all together. A lot of times the most musically gifted has that knowledge of music theory and so forth, and a lot of times even the best looking guy. Of course, in this case, that's me. My name's Rich Gray. I sing the lead part, and I'm happy to be here. Yeah, I am. Sorry, buddy. And that leaves the tenor singer. Tenor singer over here on my far left. He hails from Morristown, New Jersey, way far upstate here, a couple hours away. He works in the IT field. He's a computer gadget junkie, and he can kind of fix everything that keeps people plugged in and connected. Although, as luck would have it, he actually had a lot of trouble with his cell phone earlier this morning. We got here early, dropped it right into his coffee cup, right smack down in the thing. Unbelievable. But now it runs Java, which is kind of nice. It runs effectively, which is nice. So please say hello to Alex Corson. We're going to feature our tenor singer Alex on this next song, and we hope that you enjoy. You may remember this one from, it's the theme from Ice Castles. Please enjoy Through the Eyes of Love.
This feeling end, it's everything I am, everything I want to be. I can see what's mine now, finding out what's true, since I found. I can see my life as it comes up shining now,
reaching out to touch you.
I can feel
so much
since I found you.
That's all right, buddy. That's all right. I love that. He's little, but he's loud. <I tell you. laughs> Little fella packs a punch, doesn't he?
That's something.
Thank you so much, folks. We're going to leave you with just one last song. You've been a great audience, as I said, and we're thrilled to be here in our very first show and air out all our mistakes in front of good-natured people like the folks of Blackwood, New Jersey, right? We'll leave you with this last one. We don't have any CDs for sale or anything like that. We're not quite commercialized yet, so we won't be taking any money for that sort of thing. We just love to shake your hand and say hello in the lobby when it's all over, so please stop by and say hi. That's only $5, so yeah. I mean, it's a quick
deal.
Yeah, exact change, please. We're not quite up and rolling just yet. So thank you very much. We'll leave you with just one more. Thank you.
It's too darn hot, it's too darn hot. I'd like to sup with my baby tonight, oh tonight. And play the pup with my baby tonight, I'd like to sup with my baby tonight and play the pup with my baby tonight. But I ain't up to my baby tonight, cause it's too darn hot. Yeah, yeah, it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. I'd like to fool with my baby tonight, oh, tonight. Yes, break every rule, oh, yeah, with my baby tonight, baby tonight. I'd like to fool with my baby tonight, break every rule with my baby tonight, but Bill, you'll be my baby tonight, cause it's too darn hot. According to the latest report, every average man you know much prefers to play his favorite sport when the temperature is low. But when the thermometer goes way up and the weather is sizzling hot, Mr. Adam Forbes, Mad Adam is not, cause it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot, baby, it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot, it's too darn hot. I'd like to coo with my baby tonight, and pitch some moo with my baby tonight. I'd like to coo with my baby tonight, and pitch some moo with my baby tonight. But brother, you'll fight my baby tonight. It's too darn hot. According to the latest report, every average man you know much prefers to play his favorite sport when the temperature is low. But when the thermometer goes way up and it's hot, 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 a marine for his queen, a G.I. for his cutie pie is not, cause it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too, oh, Dad, it's too darn hot. I'd like to stop with my baby tonight and pull my top with my baby tonight, but I'll be a flop with my baby tonight, cause it's hot. Lordy, it's too darn hot. Too darn hot.
There it is.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Fred.
I appreciate it. The smooth sounds of Urban Pool. I don't know about you, but Rich said they were sort of halfway to Carnegie Hall. I think they're going all the way. How about you? All right, without further ado, let's bring back the Pine Barrens Barbershop Chorus.
Again.
small, a vine-covered lake, my dream for tomorrow still looks the same. For though I find you're caring for someone soon, I still
traditional barbershop sound, and 187 votes for the new age acapella scene. Also, there were 51 votes, I'm sorry, that couldn't be counted due to hanging chads.
Florida.
Florida. I don't know, I just read the results. The good news, however, is that a decision has been reached between both parties, And all groups have agreed to join forces at one for this evening's finale.
All right. Thank you, Governor. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the combined Pine Barrens Barbershop Chorus along with Rowan University's Prophecy.
I woke up this morning feeling fine. Now there's something special on my mind. 'Cause last night I met a new girl in my neighborhood. Oh, oh yeah, oh yeah. Something tells me I'm into something. Something tells me I'm into something. She's the kind of girl who's not too shy, and I can tell I'm her kind of guy. She danced close to me like I hoped she would. She danced with me like I hoped she would. Something tells me I'm into something good. Something good, oh yeah. We only danced for a minute or two, but then she stuck close to me the whole night through. Can I be falling in love? She's everything I've been dreaming of.
Thank you so much. It really is a treat for the Pine Barrens Chorus to be up on stage, sharing the stage with our new good friends from Prophecy. Have they been great or what? Those are... They clean up all right in those suits, don't they? Put on their best jeans. We used to be cool too, so.
Hey, at least they're wearing ties,
yeah. We're gonna feature another song with the combined voices here, and we've got, what was that about ties? Really? Really? See if you can spot this song. It was recorded back in 1983 by the Police.
Suddenly you're gone, and
sing you and I. Have been lost without a trace. Tonight I can only see your around. You I can't replace. So cold and I long for your embrace. Baby, baby, please. Baby, please. Can't you see? Can't you see? You belong to me.
And of course, none other than the Donald. This is the moment.